What Ephrata? Let's say, what is the equation? Let's say you wanted to remove, let's put it another way, you who are math people, you wanted to remove emptiness from a vacuum. You got a zero. The emptiness is zero. How do you get zero out? You have zero minus zero equals what? You want to take away zero from zero, what are you left with? What does it equal, math geniuses? What is zero minus zero? Zero. See, I knew we were a smart group here. You take zero from zero, you still end up with zero. You can't get it out. You cannot get emptiness out, no matter what you do. Even if you try to minus five, you end up with negative, which is still nothing. You end up with the only way to get zero out, it's not by subtraction, it's by addition, is by adding something positive, then zero goes. Add the number one, add the number five, zero goes. The only way to remove the negative, the real way, is only by the force of the positive. This is key for everything in your life. So with God, sin is like a zero or a negative, a nothingness, a negative entity. The only way to remove it is not by focusing on it. Not that you don't have times that you know what it is, but that's not focusing on how sinful you are isn't going to do it. That might be a start to say, I need help, but that's not the end. That's the law, but that's not the end. That's not going to do it. That may lead you to the answer, but the only way to take that sin out of your life is by not performing subtraction, but performing addition. The positive will remove the negative in your life. How do you remove ungodliness from a human heart? You remove it, you try to move it, and see, even if you remove one sin, another sin's gonna come in if you didn't deal with the heart, if you didn't fill it up. How do you remove ungodliness? You know, it's like, in your houses, some of you, wherever there's an empty space, something starts developing there. One sock and then it becomes a tower and all this stuff. That's the way we are. It's in your schedule, it's anything. Something starts there. The only way to keep sin out is by having something else there. If you don't have something else there, it's not going to happen. If you don't have something else there that's more powerful, it's not going to happen. How do you remove ungodliness from your life? Only one way, real way, by the presence of God. That's the only way. I mean, you can remove one sin, but another sin will come. And you take out this sin. Hey, wow, I'm great. Look what I did. I got this sin out. Well, now I got pride in there. If I didn't replace it with God, pride's going to come in. I'm going to judge other people. Something else is coming in. How do you remove what's wrong with that person? You remove what's wrong by what's right, by filling it up with what's right. How do you get saved? You got saved not by becoming the perfect person you were supposed to be, not even by taking the sin out of your life. You got saved by receiving God, Jesus, into your life. And that impelled other things to get out of your life. I remember I was kind of waiting on coming to the Lord because I wanted to come to the Lord with good motives. I didn't want to come with bad motives. I didn't want to come for selfish motives. I wanted to come with good motives, so I'm waiting to get right. So I could get right. And it was like when I was growing up, once a week we had a cleaning lady who came over, and my mother, the day before, she said, quickly clean up. You don't want the house looking like this when she comes. I'm thinking, what's the point? You're cleaning up for the cleaning lady. And I realized that, I can never come to God with the best motives. If I had the best motives, I wouldn't have to come to God. The point was, once I got hit by a train, I said, okay, Lord, I'm coming. That's how it happened. But it is his presence before I can do anything else.
To find out how you can receive more of Jonathan's teachings, to receive special free gifts, or get in touch, go to hopeoftheworld.org or call toll-free 1-800-YESHUA-1. That's hopeoftheworld.org or call 1-800-YESHUA-1. That's 1-800-937-4821. You can also get more at Jonathan Kahn's Facebook page or write us direct at Hope of the World, Box 1111, Lodi, New Jersey, 07644, USA.